everybody. It's Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com. And today is day two of rebuilding the waterfall. We got a lot done yesterday. Today we started by going to get the rubber liner that will be obviously inside the lower pond. Then we have to go to Home Depot and get the lumber because we're going to have to reinforce the inner pond structure underneath before we can put the liner down. And because there's going to be rain in the forecast for the next 3 days, we're going to see how far we get today. We just wanted to let you know what our progress was for today. We've been to the roofing place, got our rubber for the linings, and we went to the Home Depot and bought all of our lumber to help rebuild the waterfall. So these biggies, well actually I think it's those biggies, are for the top pieces of the large pond that you can actually sit on when they're done, and I'm thinking red for those.
Well, I'm also rethinking how we're going to have the third tier of the waterfall too. I don't know if I'm going to have a box filled with water that overspills, or if I'm going to create some kind of a PVC tubing sculpture that spits it out.
That sounds like fun.
So.
But we're done for today. Well, we're done with this project for today. And we still have to take the straw off of the strawberries and the straw off of the garlic, because we're going to be getting some rain and we want them to get a nice soaking.
Well, we have rain in the forecast for the next 3 days,
yes,
and I'm not about to start this right now.
No, that's God telling you it's time to rest.
Yep. Actually, I'm still pooped from yesterday.
Oh, yeah. It was a hard day yesterday.
But, you know, just driving around and getting everything, I mean, that in itself is a task.
Well, and then lifting it all. Thank goodness we had help not only picking out the lumber, but then these two very nice young men helped us put it into the trailer. And then, of course, the two of us had to unload it, even though I invited those two young men over to help us, but they said, no, that'll cost more. Uh-huh. So I said, today is day three of rebuilding the waterfall. Yesterday we did a lot of running around, buying things that we needed, loading them and unloading them. And today was supposed to be a day of rest because it was supposed to be raining out. And I thought, wonderful, this will give Rick a chance to rest and recover. But oh no, it isn't raining at the moment. So he's out of my control, I guess. He's working again today. He's putting this support beam on here. When we originally put this in, we also had a 2x4 on the inside here to help give a wider base for the seating platform. But what we think happens is when this freezes in the winter, it pushes up on that board, and thus the whole board itself, the seating board, not only warped, but it moved up and then it moved forward. So we're not putting that on this time. It's going to be a seating platform with this 2x4 and then the original structure for the actual pond itself. So once this is done, then that board over there will be carried over here. Now I'm wondering, how did somebody by himself get that board over there?
I just talked to it and it gently walked over there and put itself in place.
Yeah, right. I was in the house trimming and bathing the dog, and this is what he does when I'm not watching him. While Rick was working in the back and he didn't need my help at the moment, I cut some of the Montauk daisies off. Now, from what I've read, you're supposed to cut them down each year. 6 inches was what I read, but I wanted to go a little farther. But these are actually the cuttings off of the main bush, and I just stuck them right into the ground because this is what I found works the best if you want to have new propagations off of a Montauk daisy. Don't bother putting them in water, just stick them right in the ground. And then these are the Japanese fern leaf peonies. I got as much of the root as I possibly could, and again I put those in soil, watered them well. I'll be dumping some of this water out now that I know the soil is nice and damp because it will rain tonight.
Well, we talked about dividing that Japanese fern leaf maple. It's really too clustered. Let's go over and take a look at it.
Okay. Now, here it is, and you can see it already has the buds on it, which is probably, this is a terrible time to be dividing it. But we're going to be digging around in here, and I thought, well, if anything happened, at least, you know, maybe we'll have some starters. So,
well, eventually we have to dig this completely out, probably divide it in fourth.
Yes.
And get it around. And then when our giant hibiscus right behind these daffodils starts growing, we've got to dig that out.
Right.
Divide that and find a new home for that as well.
Which means we have to dig these daffodils out before we can get to the hibiscus root.
Yep.
So we're waiting for that until the daffodils are done blooming. I'm just so happy with all the daffodils that came up. It just looks like a little fairyland everywhere. Ah, tickles me.
Well, we had people stopping, talking about how beautiful all the daffodils look on the outside too, because you have literally hundreds of them.
Well, I took all of the daffodil bulbs that we had where we were putting the library, which have been there for years and years, and I scattered them all along the edge. So all of them came up, all of them bloomed. It's amazing. They're tough. 5 hours later, and look what Rick has accomplished. He's just really amazing. He's got the understructure in place and the bench in place on both sides. He's built the box here in the third tier, which is upside down at the moment, but this will house the plumbing for the fountain. And then he decided to put a bench or a pot stand back here so we can have a display of flowers for the summer in the back here.
In containers.
In containers.
We need to find five square containers.
They could be round too.
Yeah, a square would be better.
And then, coming down this way, the next step is to line this
reinforce
lower part, right, with plywood, correct?
Yep.
Mm-hmm. And then eventually that will have rubber in it also. And then it's a matter of figuring out the plumbing, the where the pump goes, where the pipes go.
Yeah, there's still a couple of days of work before.
Yes.
But I must say we used up all the lumber pretty good.
Yes.
I think we only have a couple extra boards.
Calculated very well.
And our sheets of plywood are still under there.
They're
protected.
Under, right, because we know tonight we're going to get more rain. And now they're saying some storms, so it'll be a couple of days yet, maybe a week, depending on what other task somebody thinks of in the meanwhile.
Yep, well, let's go get the rakes and undo the strawberries and the garlic.
Indeed. We put these cages up here and some of the trellises just to keep the squirrels out, but as you can see, the squirrels got in anyway. Now it's just a matter of untangling these. For now they can just go there.
Oh, you're so impulsive.
Thanks.
Jeez. Never get in the way of a woman at work.
You got it. Trellis. Let's see if anybody's up. Hello. Good morning.
Woo-hoo. I'd say they're doing pretty well. Now, this batch is the batch that was just regular. The other one in the front is the one that we inoculated with 180 proof vodka.
Well, first fish emulsion.
Fish emulsion, yeah.
And in the past, we've had really good luck even without doing anything except planting.
Well, you know, we're an eclectic experimental garden, so we thought let's see if inoculating, giving them a bath, getting rid of any bacteria, giving them a vodka bath, supposedly will spark their growth.
We'll see. Okay, I've got to get to the other side.
I'd say it's doing very well over here.
Yes, it is.
So we planted, what, a couple hundred?
Yes, we did.
I think in both areas. So we kept the largest bulbs from our, what was that, our second or third year?
I think our second year.
Yeah. So we'll see if they get bigger this year.
A little bit on there is still fine. I probably should put a little layer over the top anyway, but for now, for its first true rainfall, should be happy.
Well, let's go do the other section.
This is our inoculated bed. The ones that we've treated with special goodies. I think they're all drunk.
It's all that vodka. They do look healthy though.
Yes, they do. After uncovering both batches, we really can't see a difference yet. So the true proof will be when we dig them up.
Yep, once we see the size of the bulbs, we'll see if it really made any difference.
Right, then we'll know. And in a little over a month, we'll probably start getting scapes, which are the flower stalks that'll come up, and those will cut off and we'll just enjoy right away.
And why do you cut the scapes off?
So that more energy will go into the bulb and not into creating a flower.
Wow. Are you ready for the strawberries?
On we go. Here we are at our strawberry patch. This is how it looked all winter, and we're excited to see how the strawberries did over the winter. So we're going to move those two bales out of the way, and then we will scrape off the straw and use it as the pathways, but also as mulch around the strawberries. Good morning.
Actually, it's good afternoon.
I think they're ready to come up. They look kind of thirsty. Well, I think we're done for today. I think we got quite a bit done, what with shopping and lugging all that wood and that rubber and then unloading it and getting it into place. Then taking the straw off not only the strawberries but also the garlic. So it's off to the showers we go again. Hope you've enjoyed this video. If you have, could you please give us a thumbs up? It always helps support our Wisconsin garden mission, and we'd love to hear from you.
All I want to do is take a shower and watch a movie.
You may do that now.
Well, thank you.
You're welcome. Bye for now. If you have any questions or comments, we'd love to hear from you. Give us a thumbs up if you would, and also if you'd like to subscribe, the little button's over here. Thank you so much for walking and for watching, and for your support in what we do. Bye for now.
Connect with us on YouTube.